Okay, thanks, Alistair. So, like Berkeley, we're in Spain and also in Portugal. We've got our two main projects, the La Perla project, which is about 250 kilometres north of Seville. That's a very large tungsten development project. Echoing what Paul just reiterated about Spain, we put in our environmental approval documents and our primary mine approval documents in March this year. We got environmental approval in July, and in November we got full development approval. So in the case of where we operate in Spain and in Extremadura, which is a very poor province, and very pro-investment, jobs and exports. Very pro-jobs and exports. we were able to go from all the documents in to all the approvals in place in effectively an 8-month period of time. So I'd echo and reiterate what Paul said about Spain and also Portugal. This is a environment, particularly in the West, where there is good support and with the right teams. And the right teams are very, very important. With the right teams, you can get the approvals through. So just back to an overview. La Perla in Spain is the flagship. It's large. It's an open pit mine. We have already actually produced Alistair. We produced from the tailings last year and produced at the beginning of this year from the tailings as well. So we've got good customers who like our product and want to buy more. Our second largest project is the Régua mine in northern Portugal. That's about an hour and a half's drive east of Porto. I was literally there yesterday and that project is coming along exceptionally well. It's about 3 times the grade of La Perla. It's getting exceptional metallurgical results, and we're looking at a very, very good low-cost project development there. We've got two other smaller projects, which I'll mention now and won't come back to later. Taroca is a high-grade former tin tungsten mine. It's got these beautiful lenses which can go up to 5% WO3 grade. We just got to find the right way to get geological control over it, and that will make a major contribution to the Régua project. And then in central Portugal, literally across the border from La Perla into in Spain into Portugal, we've got the CAA Porto Alegre project. That's gold. It's also copper gold. We've got some very interesting projects there. We think we'll have a bigger gold resource from the work that we're doing at the moment. But at the moment, our focus is very much on the two tungsten mines, La Perla and Régua. Just a little bit about tungsten for those who don't know about it. It's the world's hardest, highest boiling point metal. It's used in a whole range of applications. Big growth at the moment in automobiles, cutting tools for automobiles, cutting tools for aerospace. There was a big demand in oil and gas and mining. That's come back a little bit, but it's got a very wide range of diversified uses, including in chemicals and in military applications. So very good metal. Like a lot of commodities, the price has been a lot softer in the last 6 months. But the supply and demand fundamentals are just very strong. There's not much supply. A lot of it's controlled by China. And you know, once this industry gets out of its current downturn, where every commodity, despite some of them having tight supply conditions, comes into 2016, we're very confident about where the prices will hit. La Perla, this is our flagship. We released a development study earlier this year. We're looking at 5,000 tonnes per annum of tungsten concentrate. That's a lot larger than we were previously looking at. That produces a revenue of around about 90 million US a year and around about 40 to 50 million EBITDA. So one project can generate very good revenues and very good cash flows. We'll also produce around 400 tonnes of tin, and we have a very low operating cost structure. Paul mentioned, Alistair mentioned the announcement we had today with some of the grades. Any increase in the grades, and we're seeing some substantial ones from the recent drilling, drives that cost structure lower. So in this environment, low cost. Low cost is really important. Keeping your projects competitive, lower than the price, lower than the other players in the industry is absolutely critical. And La Perla has very low operating cost. All of that translates into a net present value of around about $125 million US dollars and a very high IRR. The reason we have a high rate of return on this project is because the capital cost to go into production is very low. Wolf, a lot of you will have known the Drakelands Hermondon project down near Plymouth. That was around about $200 million. There's a big tungsten project in Vietnam, I think one of the largest in the world, called Nui Phao. That was around $450 million. To put our project in production, we're looking at $16 million US dollars, which in today's euros, US is about 16 million euros. So we've got a low capital cost to get a low operating cost project into production, and we can do it quickly. As I said, we have produced product from this mine to date. We were producing from the tailings, and we had a very good a product that all of our customers in Europe and Israel liked. We were producing a concentrate of about 60-62. When we switch to the mine, we'll increase that concentrate grade to about 66-67, and we'll produce a tin concentrate. So we separate the tin from the tungsten, get a better tungsten product, and we get some nice byproduct credits and revenue from the tin. We've also made a lot of progress on Regua, where we've got some really good test work coming through the system, and we're confident that we can very quickly get to good commercial grade on the Regua project, which is northern Portugal. So we're not just one tungsten product producer, we're two, and our product specs are right up there with what the customers want. The key to the development of La Perla is two stages. The full mine, we're looking at 2017-2018, but the most immediate focus of the team and everything we're doing is on what we call the fast track mine. The fast track mine will produce 1,300 tonnes per annum of tungsten, 110 tonnes of tin, and has a capital cost of $16 million and an operating cost of $121 per MTU. Just to give you a little bit of context, current tungsten price is around about $170 per MTU. That's probably below the cost structure of half the industry. So we're not going to see that down there for that long, but that's where it is at the moment. We're profitable at that price, but we've got to keep driving our operating costs down to ensure we make good profits for shareholders. People ask, you know, $16 million, why did it cost Wolf $200 million? And Michael, you can start with 16. Well, there's a couple of very good reasons for that. Firstly, all of our infrastructure is in place. We have the power grid connection. We have the access to water. We're literally 3 kilometres from the main Seville-Madrid highway, and that's a 6-lane highway. So when you build a new mining project, infrastructure can cost over 50% of your costs. We've already built the infrastructure, and it's sitting there ready to go. We also we're developing a mine that has previously been in production, so we already have the tailings dam built. We already have a lot of the facilities necessary for startup that a greenfield mine wouldn't have. And importantly, we already have the concentrator. So when we were operating the tailings, we built the tailings plant that allows us using very simple gravity separation to produce a high-grade tungsten concentrator. That uses spirals, a little bit of flotation and shaking tables, and the shaking tables get you to 66% tungsten concentrate. Tungsten's very heavy. We have a coarse grain mineralogy which allows us to achieve very simple low-cost separation, and that's what gives us a very low-cost structure. To put the mine into production, we already have the concentrator, and so a lot of our focus has been on two or three key pieces of additional equipment we need to add to the mine to convert it from a mine to a tailings operation. And we essentially need a crushing circuit, probably X-ray sorters, although we're looking at whether we can drop those out of the system, and jigs. So we're not talking about a lot of capital to be able to take this mine that already has infrastructure and a concentrator and put it into production, and that's what gives us our very competitive capital costs. Put that another way, this is what we have on the ground at the moment. Classification plant concentrator. To put the mine into production, we add a jig and a mill and rearrange the conveyors. So we're talking about low incremental capital costs to put a low operating cost mine into production. I'm not very good at PowerPoint, but we had to add this morning. We drilled 3,000 metres of diamond core and also RC drilling through July and August and September. And the results are just coming through. We've been getting good results, but at the end of last week we got some very, very strong results in a location that we didn't really expect, that provide just very, very substantial opportunities to both reduce our operating cost and to increase the overall resources and grade of the project. La Perilla sits at 47 million tonnes at 0.1% WO3, or tungsten trioxide. We assumed this was the pit. We were going to focus here for the initial mine. And we drilled, and this was meant to be the extent of the mine. That was the end of it. But we drilled this hole here, and we got 40 metres of tungsten trioxide from surface at 0.32. That's three times the grade of our deposit at, you know, very significant thickness and at surface. And if you look at operating cost, if you're able to lift the grade that you feed to our plant, that drives down your unit operating cost. So again, in this environment, which everybody knows has been tough and hard, we're able and have had, you know, quite a spectacular results. There's three holes that have got similar grades on the right in the guts of where we're planning to develop the fast track mine, and we'll quickly incorporate that into our resource estimation, and then we'll quickly, although it'll be in the new year, incorporate it into our mine plans and cost structures. But the results that came through this morning are very significant in terms of opening up the ore body. We thought it finished here. All these results say it's open to the south. So very significant resource potential is added by these results. We also, up here, got some very good results as well. So we're looking at adding to a current development plan some very high-grade mining areas that do everything we need to be able to get early high-grade tonnes into our plant. So very important and significant results this morning. I mentioned approvals earlier. A month ago, that last green box wasn't ticked. It's now ticked. We're approved for development. Regua. Regua's a very good mine to follow on La Perilla. We announced in November an increase in the resource to 3.76 million tonnes at 0.3. this is a very nice high-grade tungsten deposit. We can see how overall the tonnes can increase to probably a target of 10 million tonnes at high grade. We have an obvious open pit area which we can start early production from, and we're doing some very, very good work on the mining and the metallurgical side of things to make this the substantial asset following La Perla that it is. We'll have some very good results coming through into the market in 2016 on Regua, and I keep a very close eye on that. Just as we mentioned, Regua was close to Porto, close to Taroka, which is our high-grade but lower tonnage project. About a seven-year mine life, so yeah, we're seeing a lot of upside there. Very good results through the year. This is what a section looks like, and this is probably the best way to give you a little bit of a feeling of the potential of Regua.
Hot pink and hot red is north of 3.3% tungsten. We've got an outcropping area for an easy open pit, and then we've got this very high grade zone here. The mountain comes down like that, so you can access it directly. Very high grade zone, north of 0.5% WO3, sitting right there in the middle of the ore body. Mine plans are proceeding, resources up, lots of reasons Regua is going to be a very, very good second tungsten mine for the project, for the company. I won't go into gold projects, but we do have a very nice project called San Martino, came into the portfolio 3 months ago. We'll have a nice resource on that in the new year. In terms of funding, we're very much focused on the funding for La Perla. That's going to be a key event in the new year. When you're small and got a smaller balance sheet than some of the majors, the most important thing is to have competition. So we're pursuing two principal paths for financing. One path is through joint ventures, and we're having discussions with two or three joint venture partners about coming in and taking an equity share of the La Perla project. That means we don't get dilution at the parent company W Resources level. And also, there is very strong financing facilities within Europe for projects in the poorer regions in Spain, like Extremadura, and also in areas which are strategic and in which the Europeans are nervous of Chinese control, like tungsten. So we're seeing, in parallel with the joint venture financing opportunities, quite substantial opportunities for very low-cost European financing. So we'll run those into the new year, we'll run them competitively, and we're confident that with a low operating cost project and a low capital requirement, we'll get the financing in place in the new year for the project development. So to ask the normal question, why W Resources? We've had a fantastic run this year with the share price and with shareholder support, and that's good. But if you look forward, we've got two tungsten mines which are low cost, low capital cost, and we have exceptional exploration acreage around them. La Perla is very advanced. We keep reducing the risks, we keep reducing the capital costs, and we're looking at mine production in 2016. We're following with, and it really helps having two projects running. We'll follow with Regua in 2017. We've got very, very good exploration potential, and we've been very, very successful with the drill rig. Tungsten has strong fundamentals. Yeah. We're confident the price will come back in the new year. And financing in the new year is going to be a big event, and we're making very good progress on that front. So there's some very good reasons to continue to follow strongly and invest in W Resources.
Thank you, Michael. Any questions for Michael that I can tempt out of you? Yep, there, Andrew.
And the projections of 70% IRR and the NPVs and so what price of tungsten did you use for those?
We used a long-term price so we started at $250 per MTU and increasing over time to the long-term price of $320 per MTU. That's about where we were in the middle of last year.
What do you think the payback? What's the payback period, Michael?
Payback period will depend a little bit on the price, but it's about a 12 to 18 month payback.
Right. So one thing I'm not sure if you highlighted it or not, but I'll just mention it again. I think it's quite interesting that Michael's got a significant shareholding in this company himself. So any investors in W will be provided with the assurance that the directors' interests are aligned with their own. Obviously, there is a financing coming up, so we'll have to see how the cards all fall down. But you followed it, you followed your money quite consistently throughout, haven't you?
Yeah, look, I've been in the mining industry for 20 years. I've been involved in some very successful developments and very successful financings. When you put your energy and time and your own money into a project and you understand the fundamentals, you make sure you follow through. And it's really important, in these more difficult times, to make sure that the financing transactions that our company does, but everybody else's company, are in the interest of shareholders. You can rush out and do an easy joint venture transaction, but that often is not what really gets the returns and the bottom line to the shareholders. So my experience has been in mining finance and difficult market conditions, but the key is competition from finance sources, very good fundamentals on the project, very good momentum, and that's what we're capitalising on.
There's a question at the front here.
Yeah, sorry. Charles Scott. Michael, do you regard yourself in a position now to have sufficient funds to take you up to this either this joint venture or this production agreement to enable this mine to progress, or are we going to look for further dilution of the share stocks, further placements? Are we there or are we not?
We did a small £600,000 financing in 2 weeks ago, or 3 weeks ago, and. That's strengthened the balance sheet. It's allowed us to deliver the results that we're able to deliver this morning. And it certainly gives us the financial horsepower to get us to what I call FID, final investment decision. One of the most, the period of time we're going through is one of the most important periods of time in the successful development of projects. It's what you do and it's what the management team does between now and the lead up to making a full commitment to the development of the project and getting the geology right, getting the equipment selection right, getting the right engineers in place, getting the right team in place is very important for successful execution. It doesn't cost a lot of money. If you spend the next 3 or 4 months targeting your money, keeping costs tight, but substantially advancing the project, that's the key to success. The last project I executed was the Iron Bridge project for Fortescue Metals Group in Australia. It was a big magnetite project, actually. Ended up being the largest iron ore deposit in Australia. We financed the project by selling 31% to Formosa Plastics Group for $1.2 billion. So that was a good joint venture deal, albeit in a slightly higher iron ore price environment. And we built the $350 million project in 11 months, 10% below budget. And the key to that kind of execution success and the key to getting the right joint venture partners at the right price is what you do in the next 3 or 4 months. Keep things tight, but move them forward, tighten up the project, make sure when you're ready to push the button on development that everything's tight and ready to go.
Any more questions for Michael? Ladies, oh, Paul's got a question.
Michael, I'm not aware whether Portugal has actually permitted any metal mine in some time, so I was wondering what your viewpoint was concerning the differences in permitting in Portugal versus permitting in Spain.
Well, it's in a kind of funny kind of way. Regua has had its mining and environmental permit for over a year. And what we've been doing is just making sure we understand metallurgy, because it's a greenfield project, and understand the best mine development program. So Portugal's been good. It's a greenfield project's always got different challenges to a brownfield one like La Perla, but it's in place. Actually, the largest or the second largest tungsten mine in Europe's in Portugal. That's Panasqueira. When the tungsten price was very, very low in the 1990s, because the Chinese came into the World Trade Organization and the Russians dumped their stockpiles, there was only two mines in Europe that and the Western world that kept going: Panasqueira in Portugal and WBH's Mistral mine in Austria. So Portugal's actually got a good history of mining. There's some big copper projects down south. The government's been good. It's who follows Portuguese politics, and I certainly don't understand it, but it's been a bit volatile the last 3 or 4 months, but we're not seeing that affecting what we're doing, and we've got lots of clear air with our current approvals and development plan to get on with the project. We'll most likely start with a small open pit that gets product into a concentrator and generates a good initial revenue stream, and then we'll work out the smart type way to access that high grade tungsten in the regular mine. Does that answer the question?
Well, I was wondering when Panasqueira was permitted. Actually,
I think Panasqueira has been going for 100 years.
And that's my concern, is whether or not the government is actually prepared to permit a new mine.
Oh, well, so we have a mining lease with environmental approval.
Okay, I think
the government would like us to be mining now. We just want to do a little bit more homework before we start pushing buttons.
And to make sure you get it right. I think we'll break for coffee now, ladies and gentlemen. That was a very enlightening presentation from Michael Masterman. Please join me in thanking Michael Masterman from W Resources.